Hello student, I hope you all are fine. Today we are going to study about chapter 3, the Northern Mountain. As you know student, in a previous chapter we have studied about the physical features of India. On the basis of its physical features, India can be divided into 5 main regions: the Northern Mountain, the Northern Plains, the Deccan Plateau, the Coastal Plains and Island, and the Western Desert. So today student, we are going to study about the Northern Mountain. The Northern Mountain is stretched like a great wall across the northern and northeastern part of our country. The Northern Mountain include Karakoram Range, Himalayan Range of Mountains, and Northeastern Hills. Himalayas. The Himalayas extend from Jammu and Kashmir to Arunachal Pradesh. Did you know student, Himalayas is Sanskrit means the abode of snow, home of snow. It is Himalayan. It is given this name because a large part of the Himalayas is covered with snow throughout the year. The Himalayas are the highest mountain in the world. And you know student, the Mount Everest in the Himalayas is the highest peak in the world. The Himalayas consist of 3 parallel ranges. The Himadri are the greater Himalayas, the Himachal are the middle Himalayas, the Shivalik or the outer Himalayas. The greater Himalayas, it is the northernmost range. It is the highest of the 3 ranges, always covered with snow. Glaciers are found here. What do you mean by glacier? Glacier is the moving sheets of ice. Difficult for people and animal to live here. Agriculture is not possible here. Many world's highest peaks such as Mount Everest, Mount K2, Kanchenjunga, Annapurna, etc. are part of Himadri. Many rivers like Ganga, Yamuna, Indus originate these glaciers. The Middle Himalayas or Himachal. It lies toward the south of the Greater Himalaya. This range is found between the Himadri and the Shivalik. These ranges have beautiful valleys such as Kullu and Kangra. Its range has thick forest covered with pine, oak, deodar, etc. Hill stations such as Shimla, Nainital and Darjeeling are situated here. The Outer Himalayas is also known as Shivalik. It is the southernmost and the lowest range Himalayas. Slopes covered with thick forest. Many wild animals are found in these forest slopes used for terrace farming. What is this terrace farming? Terrace farming is a method of farming whereby steps known as terraces are built on the slopes of hills and mountains. The area at the foothills of the Shivalik range is called Tarai. The government has made several protected forest areas, the Carpet National Park and Kaziranga National Park. The importance of Himalayas act as a natural boundary. Himalayas protect us from the cold wind blowing from the north. The Himalayas stop the monsoon wind from going further north and thus bring heavy rainfall to the northern plains of India. They are also a source of wood and medicine. Many useful things spread in these Himalayas. Several rivers originate in Himalayas. See this diagram. This is the northern part of the Himalayas. This is the northern part of Himalaya, northern mountains. And this is the Himalayas. And see the student. Here is the Indus. Behind the Indus is the Karakoram Range. Karakoram Range. A part of the great Himalayas that lie beyond the rivers Indus is called the Karakoram Range. Mount Gorner Austin is also known as K2 lies in this range. It is the second highest peak in the world. See the diagram here. This is area is the Karakoram range. This area is the Karakoram range, and this is the in the behind in the Indus river, and here is the K2 mount, and here is the Mount Everest here in the Nepal. The Nepal, and here is the Kanchenjunga in the Sikkim. So student, today we have studied about Himalayas, three major in the Himalayas and importance of the Himalayas. I'm giving you some question as homework. You all of you try to write the answer of given question. First question: what are the three ranges of the Himalayas? Which is the highest mountain peak in the world? And third is the famous hill station of Middle Himalaya. Thank you.